Good day to the audience around the world. Today is Monday, May 3rd, 2021, and it's now 11:30 p.m. in Taiwan. I'm Fiona, Zhang Xinfang. Welcome to the weekly report of the World New Religion, Taiwan Weixin Shengjiao at Weixin TV Station. Changjishan Weixin Shengjiao has long been dedicating to fulfilling our religious doctrines of disaster elimination, peace promotion, and charity. We also focus very much on the latest events of Taiwan, East Asia, and the world, such as climate change, food shortage, natural disasters, and major world constructions. Weixin Shengjiao expresses our care to the world in our religious way continuously. Following Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi's instruction, from April 26th to May 7th, Changjishan Weixin Shengjiao is hosting Xinchou Year Disaster Elimination Ritual for Coarse Thread Peace and World Peace. Abiding to our religious rite, the Richest Heavens Design Mandala is set up at the Heavenly Altar at Headquarters Xianfu's Temple. The mandala worships lotuses and holy seeds representing 196 countries. By reciting Weixin Shengjiao holy scriptures and making offerings to the Chinese ancestors, holy sages, and the ancestors of the leaders of the cross thread, we're depending on the power of Buddha to harmonize the underworld and the modern world. We pray for the peace of the cross thread and the world. May the world become a family.
Changjishan Weixin Shengjiao launched the Xinchou Year Disaster Elimination Ritual on 26th for Cross Strait Peace and World Peace. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi led Weixin versus fellows with whole hearts sincerely to invite the Jade Emperor, Wanchang Laozu, Buddha's Bodhisattva sages and deities, and the God of all nations descend to the mountain world to bless Cross Strait Peace and World Peace. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi instructed Weixin versus fellows by saying that,
那么在天坛呢，这个坛呢是天机坛，是两岸和平、世界和平的圣坛。那由幻辈学院袁松院长所带领的幻辈法师啊一起来公众诸经来回向，回向给。 上帝、阿拉、玉皇大帝、诸佛菩萨，仰仗天威加持，两岸和平、世界和平、天下太平啊！所以我们从今天3月15日开始升坛，到了3月26日圆满。 这段时间呢，我们各位维新弟子比较辛苦一点，大家同心同德，大家一起来本着为国修道、为人类祈福的本愿，我们来把它圆满。整个的过程法仪是殊胜的，整个的过程。 怀疑我们的目标是一致，世界和平，两岸和平，天下一家亲呐！所以我们在这里勉励各位同修，大家来，一起来共修，也祝福各位，大家平安，大家身体健康，福慧增长。
On every morning, we have five chanters of Weixin Chanting College started the altar by chanting scriptures, summoning Dharma realm spirits, offering flowers, fruits, and delicacy, lighting seven-color lotus, and offering yoga flaming mouth rite for a Xinchou Year disaster elimination ritual. We hope grievances can be resolved, disasters can be eliminated, the three Chinese ancestors can be benefited and be reborn in the Buddha Pure Land. We also prayed that a merciful Jade Emperor will resolve the grievances among sons and daughters of the three ancestors from both sides of the street. Then the southern heavenly gate will be opened from the ninth Bodhisattva with one wish, which is the world as one family. Weixin Report, Nantou.
On the same day and the same venue, in the afternoon, Director Yuan Xin of Research and Development Center for the Religious Affair of Weixin Shenjiao invited Korean Professor Taesu Kim to give a lecture of the birth and development of Korean new religious thoughts in the East Asian context for inspiring attendees of the lecture training program of Yijin University with profound religious knowledge.
Korean Professor Taesu Kim gave a lecture at the Lecturer Training Program of Yijin University on April 24th in the headquarters Shenfosi Temple. This lecture is presented by Master Yuan Ping, Dean of Lecturer Training Department, and hosted by Yuan Xin, Director of Center for Religious Affairs, to invite Korean Professor Taesu Kim to introduce the origin and development of Korean new religions, discuss the three main new religious movements, including the Donghak Cheongdo-gyo, Kangzhensan, Taesun Thought, and Taejong-gyo. Moreover, Professor Taesu Kim talked about the continuities and discontinuities with Chinese religious tradition from different segments as archaeology, culture, anthropology, DNA research, and the history of thought. Professor Taesu Kim is the Vice Minister of Taesun Academy of Science, the professor of Daeju University in Korea and the visiting professor of National Chenju University, who does in-depth research of the thoughts of new religions. Grandmaster Huyan Chanshi attended the lecture to welcome Professor Kim, who gave the lecture about the thoughts of the new religion in Korea for the lecturer training program. Grandmaster instructed that
中华文化, 在亚洲, 因为历史的恩怨情仇，所以说不清，理也理不完的恩恩怨怨是非，所以延伸了，在一起演进了，各自奔波。无论在地球上的哪一个国家，尤其在东亚、东南亚的地区。 人民都有血脉同宗同源的因缘。那么今天，我们中华三族儿女，经过世代的演化变化万千，啊，有的到韩国，有的到日本，到各国去了。唯独离我们最近的。 就是韩国，在韩国，它的血脉到底是从什么时候开始？那个考证需要有相当的智慧，所以尤其我们中华文化与韩国的文化。 非常的相近，韩国的文化，它的文明是中华文化相融合，到底是韩国的文化到中原来，或者中原到韩国，那个不重要，最重要的。 我们要有一个心，大家都同样住在一个地球，大家都要相互的尊重和尊敬，这样我们人生才会有意义。Grandmaster
reminded virtuous fellows that only by having the complete understanding among humans' hearts can our spirits combine together without resentment. Director Yuan Xin introduced Professor Kim to the audience about his research interest and professional field firstly, and then Professor Kim started to give the lecture, The Birth and Development of Korean New Religious Thoughts in the East Asian context to present the origin of Dongyi, Korean Peninsula, Hongshan culture and DNA research to deduce the origin and migration path of Korean, the origin and development of Chinese characters which become the Dongyi civilization simultaneously. Additionally, Professor Kim mentioned about the Korean religious culture, the origin and development of different new religious movements deeply. As given a culture journey in Korea, everyone gained a great knowledge from the lecture and had a nice round of applause for Professor Tae-soo Kim. Weixin reports, Shenfosi Temple.
Take a break. We will come back soon. For this week's Yijing Feng Shui Education News, first, we're presenting you the serial lectures of general education. In the morning of April 24th, the second seminar was held at the Thousand Buddha Zen Hall of Headquarters Shenfosi Temple. Exceptional keynote speakers were invited by Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chanshi and Ding Yang Jidong of Weixin Zong Nantian Cultural Center to make exchanges with the participants regarding Yijing Feng Shui research. Have a look.
长期山 Weixin Zong Jiao Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chanshi has long been implementing the concept of sustainable development of Weixin Zong Jiao in order to polish the teaching skill of masters and lecturers to guide fellows to better solve their problems, as well as the skill of Dharma propagating and Yi Jing divination. President Mr. Yang Jidong organized a second session of the Seminar of General Education, proceeding at Changjishan Xianfosi Temple, Thousand Buddhas Zen Hall on 24th of April. The speaker were President Ms. Wang Qifang and Mr. Yang Jidong. All fellows of lecturer trainee program attended. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chanshi also attended and focused on topics about culture, literature, team momentum, and organization efficiency. The seminar was held by President Yang, who reminded fellows to learn the related knowledge with focus.
言川，川流不息的在讲，所以也许各位会听到一些耳熟能详的话语，也许会觉得说这种话老生又常谈，怎么老是在谈那些东西？ 那为什么会这样？就是因为它很重要。如果不重要、不珍贵的话，就也许一谈就没了。所以，我也很希望我们这个讲座能够在各位的一起努力之下，你们纲要就像你的书一样。 旁边折一折，记一点笔记，记一点东西，或者另外拿一点纸头，我想这个是做功课需要的功夫，所以请各位大家一起来努力。Grandmaster
Hun Yuan Chanshi delivered speech to instruct fellows.
本维新圣教，我们的法脉传承是中华文化道统。 一脉一以贯之，正如我们的至圣孔子先师，他的一句话，让我们领悟：无道一以贯之，道一以贯之。 最开始就7355年前的伏羲氏羽化开天，再化辟地，一直延续到了 孔子时候啊，一直接续下来，又到我们当下，这是生命文化的生命一以贯之。所以我们研究中华文化道统易经风水，我们一定要有一以贯之的智慧思想和心念。在本维新圣教成立38年来，我们所修所行所学的都是一以贯之，是人类生命的延续，到未来千秋万世都是不生不灭的。所以最近啊，我跟梁院长商量邀请我们国内外知名的长者、专家、教授、校长，请他们啊将这一生所悟、所传、所留的智慧啊，能够再帮我们维新圣教易经大学的所有学同修啊，大家一起能够来啊探讨吾道一以贯之。
Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi said, "Our lives were eternal. We have to learn I Ching Feng Shui with a religious mindset, which reflect how sincere we are." The seminar began with the topic Culture and Literature 24 Solar Terms, sharing the precious knowledge of Chinese culture and literature by President Huang, who started the implementation with the current solar term, Green Ring.Chinese culture is originated from courtesy, from which extends to dining and leisure and etc. It then combines with arts to derive the amazing Chinese culture. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi responded to President Huang that the solar term is also related to the flower life cycle as well as I Ching Feng Shui. To explore the mystery in the nature,We should be aware of the location of flower. It always means something when each single creature appears. President Yang then moved to the topic, team momentum and organization efficiency, to share how to boost the team efficiency with existing resources. He insisted that the importance of altruism, contribution and consistency to encourage all the audiences.Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi instructed our lives are full of experience, but we own nothing till the end of lives. It is about subtle philosophy. He alerted fellows with the quote from senior master Chan Yun, "We come to the earth until 100 years old, living without carrying even a roof tile, nor with family, wealth, or reputation, but with troubles." Weixin reports, headquarters Xianfo Si Temple.
Take a break. We will come back soon. Chanjishan Weixin Shenjiao Headquarters Xianfo Si Temple hosts the one-day Zen event on the last Sunday of every month. On April 25th,Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi gave a lecture of the Diamond Sutra for the virtuous cultivators and the believers. Let's have a look.
好，我要为各位来谈解《金刚经》和当下的世间事。《金刚经》是在阐述唤醒人的觉性。良知啊，在启发众生三次因果，当下的果 就是过去的因，而现在的因，也就是未来的果。
On April 25, Chanqishan Weixin Shengjia One Day Zen event with Thousand Buddha was held in Thousand Buddha Zen Hall at the headquarters Xianfo Si Temple. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi studied the altar for the fellow cultivators and public and gave a ceremony on the Zen interpretation of the Diamond Sutra and worldly affairs.Using the law of cause and effect to awaken the public to realize their self-nature. Grandmaster instructed the fellow cultivators.
在因因果果果果因因，我们一定要很小心，否则的话，犯了种下了不好的因，一定会不好的果。种下善的因，就有未来善的果。这是礼貌不爽。
Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi has been instructing fellow cultivators to practice spiritually to attain the status of sage and Buddha. Do not just learn the methods. One will only become a practitioner of arts but not the spirits. Therefore,On the last Sunday of every month, he would practice spiritually with fellow cultivators from all over the place by giving talks, explaining the sutras at Thousand Buddha Zen Hall. By broadcasting the event through the TV network, fellow cultivators in other locations can participate in the event together. Through the teachings of the Grand Master,It is hoping that all fellow cultivators will realize self-nature and attain enlightenment. By following the Dharma and abiding religion, every cultivator can become a saint or a sage and realize their Buddhahood and cultivating people who are beneficial to the society, rather than teaching some practitioner of the arts. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi,also encourage the fellow cultivators that a single moment in time is to be a monk at home with a thought. That to be a monk is to leave the worries, and that is to be a monk. The fellow cultivators following the instructions of Wang Chan Lao Zhu, reciting the sutras at home by following the Dharma, is the same as becoming a monk.By following the Dharma and abiding religion, the fellow cultivators should practice spiritually and recite the scriptures at home to complete reciting 4.8 million chapters of scriptures, so that Taiwan can continue to be safe and all countries in the world can also to be safe. Weixin Report, Headquarters Xianfo Si Temple.
The Water and Land Dharma Service of Wang Chan Lao Zhu Birthday Celebration for National Protection and Disaster Elimination is held from May 1st to May 8th. For the safety and blessings of Taiwan and the world, Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi is encouraging our virtuous cultivators and believers to recite chapters of scriptures and sutras of totally 4.8 million times.Here, we are showing you the preparatory meeting at Taoyuan Branch Temple on April 25th for the latest updates of the Water and Land Dharma Service.
On April 25th, Chanqishan Weixin Shengjia Taoyuan Branch Temple, Master Yuan Peng presided the preparatory meeting for cooking volunteers in upcoming Water and Land Dharma Service of this year.Master Yuan Peng reminded all the fellow cultivators to bear all working details in mind and hoped everyone to complete the Dharma affairs of this year's ritual collectively. First, Master Yuan Peng highly appreciated everyone's efforts in completing every year's Dharma affair of Water and Land Dharma Service assigned to Taoyuan Branch Temple.We not only should thank for the mission from Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi and each class leader's hard work for arrangement, but also express our gratitude to all participants in doing good works. Without each and everyone's efforts can never accomplish the assigned mission. It is the first year for Taoyuan Branch Temple to be in charge of cooking vegetarian delicacy food and meals. Mr. Lin Mingji was appointed as the director of volunteer groups. Mr. Liao Qiguang was deputy director. Ms. Luo Huimei was the group leader. The planning and allocation of whole cooking volunteers' works was managed by and shared among these three virtuous fellows. In response to the prevailing situation of epidemic prevention, Director Mr. Lin Mingdi reminded that all fellow cultivators and volunteers were requested to wear their surgical mask all the time during water and land dharma service. Moreover, make sure to wear necessary clothing like waterproof and slip-resistant work shoes to help avoid kitchen accident. Take care individual physical health and mute our voice while worshipping Buddhas. We have to complete the assigned Dharma affairs and also take good care of our physical safety. In the end, Master Yuan Peng and his wife encourage all virtuous fellows to cultivate merit for themselves, wish all fellows growth with blessings and wisdom, peace and joy to their families. Weixin Report, Taoyuan Branch Temple.
The water and land dharma service of Wang Chan Laozu birthday celebration for national protection and disaster elimination is coming on May 1st to May 8th. We sincerely welcome our friends and believers around the world to register for the grand event. Together, we should worship the ancestors, recite scriptures and sutras, which will benefit ourselves, our family, business, and transfer the blessings for Taiwan and the world. Thank you for joining us today. Please stay tuned at 11:30 p.m. on every Monday and 11:30 a.m. and 4 p.m. of the local time in Taiwan on every Tuesday on Weixin TV. Wang Chan Laozu bless you. See you next week.